Hello guys, welcome to SWK Tutorials. Today tutorial is how to create water puddle on road using Vray for Maya. After watching this tutorial, you can easily create water puddle on road plus other materials like mud on sand, rust on object, etc. It's slightly tricky, but I will teach you water puddle in just simple steps. So without any further ado, let's get started. Step 1. Apply checker and unwrap the road. The first step that you need to do is to unwrap this road. This road. Like this. In your UVW editor and save it snapshot. If you want to know about unwrapping, I have put its link in the description. Since this tutorial is about Vray materials, so I will skip unwrapping part. Step 2. Create a Vray blend material. Select the road object and assign a Vray blend material. Right click. Assign new material, go to Vray and click Vray blend material. A Vray blend material simply combines multiple materials in different ways on top of each other. They are very similar to Photoshop layers. Base layer is at the bottom. Coat layer 0 is on top of base layer. Coat material 1 is on top of coat material 0 and so on. Since we are creating water puddle on road, it means that the road material will be at the bottom, that is base material, and water material will be on top of road material, that is coat material 0. So, click the base material slot and create a Vray material. Name this material road. Now, click the diffuse color slot. Click on file. Click browse and assign this texture from textures.com. I will put its link in the description. Press 6 on the keyboard if you can't see your texture. Road texture here. Next, the road texture size is too big. So, to decrease the road texture size, I have to increase my repeat U and V. Go to your hypershade, select the road, click on input-output connections here and now. This is my road, this is my texture and this is its place 2D node. Double click on this node. Now, you can also do it from here, but I will be doing it from here. They are nearly identical. Now, to decrease my road texture size, I will increase my repeat U and V to 30 and 30. By increasing the repeat U and V, I am repeating my texture. This is making it small. Next, again go to your hypershade. Select, double click on your road texture. And go to your bump and normal mapping rollout. In the bump slot, click here. Click on file and browse the height map of the same texture I have put here. Now again, I have to click on hypershade and this time this bump map, I have to put the same values I have put in normal map, color diffuse map. If this is 30-30, then it also has to be 30-30 so that they both match. plus the bump multiplier. I will increase it to 40. Remember, I have already tested these values, so that's why I'm directly putting them to save the tutorial time. Your values can be totally different from mine. Now render the scene. Save the render. The road texture is okay now. Now we need to create water puddle on the road. So click on the road and we are back to our blend material. Since the water will be above the road, so we have to click on add new item to create a coat layer. Then we will create a Vray material here and name it water. Next, set the diffuse color to black, reflection color to approximately white, like .200 value, something bright white. Change the glossiness to 0.96. But no refraction. Remember, whenever you are using blend material, you are not allowed to use refractions at any cost, else you will get unrealistic results. Now render the scene. Now on render, we see water on the whole road because it is a top layer. If you click here, you can see water is the top layer. So we see water on the whole road. But we want water puddle on the road, so we have to control this water. Now to control water, we will create a water puddle texture map on the road UVs we have created in step 1 and put it in the blend amount here. So open the UV snapshot we have created in step 1 in Photoshop. Now in Photoshop, click here, give it a name of UV so that you can remember it, lock it, create a new layer, drag it below the UV layer, make sure this color is black, click on paint bucket tool and click here. Next, make sure the foreground color is white, click on brush tool. You can use a little bit hard brush and then come. Now the places where you want water, you paint it like this. Make all of these part white. Remember, in this texture the white part will be the water and the black part will be totally road. Something like this. And you can also use a Gaussian blur of 1 or 2 pixels here to make it a little bit soft. It's all up to you. Then close it like this and save your image as a PSD or JPEG. It's up to you. This is the final map that I will be using. So in my blend amount, I will click here. Again, I will click on file. I will click here and I will choose my road UV reflection map. Now again, click on hypershade. Click on Vray blend material and click on input output UVs like this. You can see here. Your base material is your road material and your coat material is your water material. And coat material, this coat material also has a reflection map which is in the blend amount, that is, that will be controlling the water. Now guys, render again. Okay guys, so you can see the result. Previously, if you remember, the water was on the whole road, but now I'm using this texture and you can see clearly here. Look at this. Look at this part. It's over here like this. And you can see this part, it is over here. And this part, it is over here. You can see this part, the water is nearly gone from this side. So guys, this is how you are going to control your water puddle. But if you look closely, the render look a little bit strange. The reason for this is that whenever you use the texture map in the blend amount, you need to adjust the opacity to opacity. One means it will only show the coat material, this coat material, that is right now water material. But if I change it to 0, it will totally show the base material, means it will not show the coat material. So I will change it to 0.5, which means that 50% coat material, water material will be shown, and 50% base material, road material will be shown. Now render again. The render looks nice now, but I still want little bit more dark water, means I don't want that much road to be visible. I want little bit less road to be visible. So I will increase my opacity from 0.5 to let's say 0.6 and render again. This will show more water and less road. Now I am happy with my result. Okay guys, a quick summary of what we have done in this tutorial. The first step is that you have to create the UVs for the road. Step 2, you have to apply a blend material on the road. Step 3, you have to create a road material in your base material because it will be sitting at the bottom. Step 4, you have to create a coat material and it should be water, but the water will be on the whole road. Next step, you have to create a blend amount texture map that will be controlling the water. And the last step is that you have to control your opacity. If you like this tutorial, give it a like. If you love it, subscribe to my channel, share my videos. Keep creating guys. Bye bye.